This was prompted by something that came up on Bridge Winners, and also something that my bridge partner Bob had a problem with, and between all of us, we kind of got this figured out now. So I've realized that I've set the table up in a hurry, and I forgot to make it invisible. If you do that and you leave seats open, you're going to get every outlander in the world trying to sit down at your table. So we're going to go back and do it right. Okay, we've got this fixed. So now we're going to open up Deal Source and see what's going on there. Now this audio might not sync up exactly with the cursor and where I am actually on the video, but it's close enough. You're going to see Use Random Deals. That just lets the computer deal all your hands for you. Not very good for most teaching situations. You can also try advanced, and I don't even want to talk about that. Or you can use save deals. And so I've tried using save deals, and just to let you know how silly I can get sometimes, I spent 2 hours trying to put together deals under use save deals, and it just wouldn't save them and wouldn't save them and wouldn't save them. Until if I'd had any hair left, I'd have yanked it all out. Then today when I was working with Bob, trying to go through the same thing, I had a little kernel of memory from 5 or 10 years ago when I was actually doing this stuff with students and said, oh yeah, I remember there's a trick to it. So we'll see if we can't get synced back up now. So to make that part work, you've got to go somewhere else. And the somewhere else that you've got to go is over on the right hand side, and you've got to open up that one that's yellow now. It's called Account, and then go up at the top and look around up there. Use the right arrow if you have to, if it's not big enough, and you go to somewhere up there, Deal Source, I guess it says. It's awfully small when I'm looking at it here, and look what just popped up. Does that look familiar? Okie dokie. So now, those, by the way, yours is probably not going to look like that. This is from years ago when I was creating it and creating a whole bunch of categories that I was going to put a lot of different hands in, and then all my students quit. So that was the end of that. Anyway, so if you do this, up pops a box, and just like the old Deal Master that maybe you're familiar with, now you can start setting up hands and making them work. And so notice up in the middle of that green screen, it tells you what hand you're going to start with. So you put a hand together based on a hand that you remember, or a hand that you have in front of you on a piece of paper or somewhere in a file, and just start constructing it. I was constructing this hand from memory of one that I played with Bob a little earlier, and we called it a Boris hand, which is his name for hands that Boris Shapiro of Shapiro and Reese over in England taught him to use to how to bid when he was a young pup first learning bridge at the Mayfair Club. Anyway, Boris hands are 1444 any one. And so you're going to see that materialize here in a minute. This is going to take a while. I'm kind of stalling right here as I'm watching this video go, because this is not an easy process. You'll note on the lower right-hand side of that area, there's something about importing LIN files. I wish I knew more about that. I absolutely don't know anything about that. If somebody can create a video to explain that, show how to do it, I sure would appreciate it, because there's a whole bunch of people out here like me that haven't got a clue when it comes to that stuff. And if you can make it easy, that'd be wonderful. Anyway, I ran into problems remembering the hand, so I pulled it up, and there it is. And again, this might be a little bit out of sync, don't worry about it. So I realized that I didn't have things quite right, and I started making corrections. And the interesting thing is that when you correct one hand by putting in a card that you have in another hand, it takes that card out of the hand that you have it in, or does something, it doesn't let you create a 52 or a 50, I mean a 53 or a 51 card deck. And you guys know I don't play with a full deck. So anyway, you need to just kind of play with this. And again, I'm stalling. I think what I'm going to do is cut the voice here and then just cut to the chase in the video, because this will take an awful long time for me to sit down and correct all this. So we're going to cut the sound off for right now. Okay, I cut out a whole bunch of me trying to select cards, and we're almost at the end of this thing, and something very interesting has happened. Again, I may be a little out of sync here, but it tried to tell me I was finished, and I looked at it and I said, that's not right. How do I fix this? And there's a little button under that yellow bar that says shuffle cards, and that's where you fix it. So I did that and I got what I wanted, and we went from there. Once you think you have it right, and it thinks you have it right, you got 52 cards placed somewhere in four sets of 13. Now it's going to ask you to tell it the exact sequence of bidding and play. I recommend that you don't do that unless you're really deliberately trying to show a sequence, like if you're teaching a hand on four different ways to play it and why one works better than the other. That's the only reason to use that. So I kept fooling with this thing until I finally got that pesky King of Diamonds where he belonged. And then it's about time to put this where the whole hand belongs. And so there's a little thing on the lower right hand side that says export. It's a little blue button, and you're going to hit that. So we're about finished here. Once you hit the export button, it'll pop up something that says save deal as. You can name it. We named this one Boris Hand Number 1, and it'll ask you where you want to put it, and you choose from the menu that pops up where you want it, and you save it, and now you go back to your table and you click on deal source, and you look for saved deals, and you go to where you saved it and click on it and hit select, and close that box. Don't hit the back or close key, the exit key. Just click close that box and then go back and redeal, and it ought to work. And by golly, there's the Boris hand right there. And that's how you do it. Whew!